Yeah, God, we thank you that you are great and awesome God. We are not the emperor, you are the true emperor. As we go ahead with the wedding ceremony and the rest of the day, I pray that you will magnify yourself, and Lord, that we will be your humble servants as we proclaim your gospel. In Jesus' name I pray, man.
Amen. Amen.
You know what, when they say,
"Who's your mother?"
What's up, guys? I'm here to get my bride. What's my Huang Ho?
I, David Su, take you, Jessica Cole, to be my wife as we stand before God and man. I promise to work together with you to be vessels for His service in accordance with His plan, so that in all areas of our life, Christ will have preeminence.
I, Jessica Cole, take you, David Su, to be my husband. I promise, according to His enabling power, I promise to submit myself to you in all things as unto Christ, because in His sight we shall be one. Through His grace, David, we might grow together into the likeness of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, to death or till Jesus returns.
Therefore, David and Jess, I now proclaim you husband and wife. Now, it is true that David has a 2-second delay in answering questions, but I'm pretty sure there will be no delay with my next request. David, you may now kiss your bride.
Hi everyone, I'm David, and she's Jess. First of all, I want to specially thank P-Ben and Faith for flying over to witness our wedding, and P-Ben for preaching at our wedding. By God's grace, P-Ben, your faithful preaching has transformed our minds and lives. Thank you for investing hours and hours sitting down with us individually to show us what God has spoken in the Bible. We both were really worshiping our own version of Jesus. We claimed that Jesus was our Savior, but subconsciously we denied Him as King. We even went to Australia thinking that we could make a name for ourselves. We had one arm around Jesus and many arms around financial stability, career progression, what people thought about us. But even though we don't deserve it, He used you and faith to open our eyes, the eyes of our hearts, to see the magnitude of God's love shown in Jesus toward us. Dad, I thank God for you. I thank God that by His grace, the gospel reached you, and therefore to our family.
To... Just practicing.
Relax,
practicing.
Relax.
Thank you for showing me a glimpse of the grace of our Heavenly Father, because I rebelled against you so many times in so many ways, but you forgave me and welcomed me back into your house. I thank God for you, Mom. Thank you for looking after our family by providing everything we need more than we can ask for. Thank you for putting our interests above yours to a point of caring about the details of what we do. Thank you for modeling persistent, steadfast love such that when I reject you sometimes, you continue to love me.
First off, to Dad, thank you for retiring early, Dad. You could have earned more money, but you were intentional to get to know us on a deeper level. Thank you for being the composed peacemaker, clear leader and reliable father figure in our family. To Mom, thank you for always putting our family before yourself and reminding me of the value of rest. Though during the wedding prep, I also needed to remind you. Thank you for serving our family so tirelessly all these years. To God, thank you for being so sensitive and loving. Thank you for being the big bro I can count on to stand up for me. You've got my back and I'll have yours too. To Tse, thank you for taking care of me and teaching me when I was younger. And when I came back from Australia, thank you for reminding me also to trust in the sovereignty of God to save and to find rest and comfort in Him alone and not in my capability. Dear family, even though I'm starting a new family unit with David, you are all irreplaceable, and because David and I know Jesus, He will teach us how to love you guys even more. Ama, kamsia le. Wa soi gai si hao le jiao gua. Le si si gai ting ho gai ama. Kamsia le.
Sisters, I thank God for you for being role models of grace. It was clear that growing up, more attention was given to the boys in the family. But you showed me countless grace. Not only that, you loved me and blessed me generously with what you have. Bro, I'm referring to my brother, Peter. I really thank God for His grace and mercy upon you and how you are serving God wholeheartedly. I thank God that for the amazing partnership in the gospel that we have. I only pray that my partnership with you and our family will grow more and more. Ama, ngô hô gắm tê chi e so e yang tim nang go le a thai to ngô kip fan to tê le tui ngô ghe oi yu yang tim ngô yu wing yun kê chi e mama. 我很感谢你对我多年的爱与支持，谢谢您让我看到您和公公的恩爱，使我看到了耶稣对教会的爱。 To the groomsmen, I thank God for the union. I thank God for the union and the partner and the relationship we have in Christ. I only pray that as we get married one after another, we will grow in our partnership and unity in our faith.
To my bridesmaids, y'all call yourselves the Noir Bride Tribe, but actually y'all are super ons. Thank you so much for all the planning and being my gospel partners that I will go to when I'm having issues with David. Thank you for being the people that I will also go to when I need rebuke and encouragement to remain steadfast in Jesus.
Lastly, thank God that through knowing Christ in Australia, God graciously gave me the opportunity to meet Jess, who was seeking to know Him too. I want to thank God for you, Jess, for your grace towards me. Because despite the many times I made you cry and hurt you with my words, you forgave me and loved me. I only pray that in this marriage, God will sanctify us and grow in our unselfish love for each other, that others may see Christ's love for His church. We have committed not to say these three words until we are married. And now that I've made a lifelong promise, I can finally say, I love you. So, I love you, Jess.
Now the soup, finally I can say, I love you too. Thank God for His grace, that in knowing Him, we can also know how to love each other. For me to willingly and joyfully submit first to Jesus as I said so in my vow, and then to you. This year has really felt like a massive countdown to the wedding. And in my joy, there was also fear of loving you more than Jesus. But thank God time and time again that He showed me that expecting so much from you, you can never give me basically what I need. The security and significance that I demand, because only Jesus can give me that. I promise, with God's help, to be steadfast in prayer for you and our marriage, so that in reflecting the relationship between Jesus and His people, others may be drawn towards Him too. By God's grace, both Soup and I know Jesus, and the glamour of the wedding will be gone in literally about 3 hours. And similarly, our lives will all fade away. And so that's why our greatest hope is that you will take away the invitation to consider a little bit more about this historical figure called Jesus.
Very first time, Mr. and Mrs. David Soup. Rise to welcome us.
Welcome back, Mr. and Mrs. David Soup!